I wondered if there would be a quarterback battle between Bryce Young and Bear Bryant's great-grandson Paul Tyson, but it looks like after today's spring game, we have our answer, and that is no. Bryce Young is going to be the guy for Alabama in 2021, and he is going to be a star. So yeah, let's briefly talk about who Bryce Young is, what he brings to the table for Alabama, and why everyone is so high on him. The kid had an illustrious high school football career and was expected to be the next big thing coming into college, so now his time has arrived and the future is now. Before we get into that, be sure to hit that like button if you want to support what I'm doing here on YouTube, subscribe if you love college football content, suggest what topic or player I should do next, and turn on post notifications so you never miss when I upload. Now let's go ahead and get started. I would like to deep dive into the career of Bryce Young as we get closer to the season, but today we're going to briefly talk about his illustrious high school career, what he brings to the table, and how good I think he can be for the Tide in 2021. So let's first go back in time and talk about how Young became a big-time quarterback name to begin with. He grew up as a Cali kid, of course, and was a big-time player and athlete from the very beginning. He originally went to Cathedral High School, but would transfer to the prestigious Mater Dei High School to finish his career. During his high school career, he passed for over 13,000 yards and 152 touchdowns, and was a 5-star recruit and an All-American. Like all quarterbacks from that high school, Young chose to commit to the USC Trojans, and this was a huge win for Clay Helton and the USC staff. He was going to be the natural replacement to JT Daniels for the Trojans, but as we know, he is at Georgia now, and Keaton Slovis is the guy now. But we have to stop because he never ended up being a USC quarterback, and he actually would flip his commitment. He backed out of his USC pledge and flipped to Nick Saban and company Alabama. USC had a mess of an offseason with three different coordinators, Keaton Slovis emerged after JT Daniels' injury, and there became the worry that he'd have to wait to play or have to actually battle out a couple guys to win the job. Instead, he opened his eyes to Alabama and would be the natural successor to Tua Tagovailoa. It didn't play out perfectly his freshman year while he was there, but we will get to that in just one second. According to 24/7 Sports, Young was a 5-star recruit, the number one quarterback, the number two overall player in his class, and the 20th best high school recruit of all time. He was expected to walk in and win the job, but after taking down multiple Heisman finalists, Mac Jones had something to say about that as he went out to win the starting job, have a historic year, and win a title for the Tide. Young was the backup and got a year with the Nick Saban system, and he'll now have a new offensive coordinator after Sark left for Texas and Bill O'Brien came in. Now it's going to come down to Bryce Young, Bear Bryant's great-grandson Paul Tyson, and blue-chip freshman Jalen Milroe for the starting job in 2021. Nothing has been official yet, but now it looks like Young will be the starter going into the 2021 season. Actually, I'm going to say it, Young will be the starter for the 2021 season, and today's spring game just affirmed that thought. Bryce Young stepped into the first-team quarterback role and impressed during their spring game today. He won MVP after completing 25 of 44 passes for over 333 yards, one touchdown, and no interceptions. Here's what Coach Saban had to say after the game. "We continue to work on him kind of having that presence out there that affects other people in a positive way, and I think he's starting to get more and more respect from the other players by the way he plays. But every scrimmage we had had, he had performed really well, and I thought he performed well today." Nick Saban doesn't usually talk a whole lot, but right there he gave out some praise and respect, and the fact that Bryce is starting to win over his teammates shows that he is likely going to be the guy this fall. So yeah, Bryce Young is likely going to be the guy, and there are some question marks like his height, some of the turnover issues he had today, and how new offensive coordinator Bill O'Brien will fit, but I think they'll be just fine, and if anyone can solve this problem, it'll be Nick Saban and his coaching staff. I think Young will have a really good year, and I don't quite think he'll get them to the national title, and once again, I'll probably be wrong with that statement, but I just think his year will maybe be next year instead of this year, and I think he is destined to have a great matchup with DJ Uiagalelei in the near future. And I do think that Bryce Young has potential to win the Heisman. I haven't seen enough out of him yet, and we'll have to see how he performs this fall. I do expect him to be one of the top players in the country and in the SEC, though, and Alabama will definitely be in the national title hunt. So what does this mean for the rest of the quarterbacks on the roster? Well, Jalen Milroe doesn't really have to worry because he's a true freshman, and he'll likely redshirt. But that can change. If Paul Tyson decides to enter the transfer portal like I think he will, Milroe might be forced to be the backup instead and not use his redshirt season. After that, I think Milroe will battle it out with 5-star incoming freshman for the 22 class, Ty Simpson, and both those guys will duel it out for the job in the future, but that is for another video. Overall, what do you guys think? If you're an Alabama fan, what do you think of Bryce Young and how he did today? How do you think the Tide will do in 2021 so far? And how good will Bryce Young be in the future? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. And be sure to let me know another player, coach, topic, or video I could do next. Give the video a like, subscribe if you're new, and check out all my other videos on the end screen, including my video about what happened to Blake Sims. Hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.